Greetings, this is Charles McCall again with Mentoring and Growing Leaders. And we're coming into the final lesson on a mini-series on the five levels of leadership. And again, I'd just like to remind you, this is crucial for a leader at any level to understand. We believe everybody has the potential to lead at some level. So when you look at your staff, you look at your volunteers, if you're a business, if you're an organization, you look at your clients, if you're a government entity, if you're a church, if you're a school, you look at your teachers, you look at your cleaner. And I'm just telling you, this is the way that I have lived for 35 years. 35 to 40 years that I've been involved in leadership. This has been my thinking. I look at the cleaner, I look at the person that seems to have not very much capacity and not very much potential, but I believe there is something there, and I believe that I can help them rise to a level of leadership. But it's important to understand there are five levels of leadership. And again, just to summarize, I encourage you go back to lesson number one and view them in sequence. But the first lowest level that we all, most of us are at, is what we call the capable person. Good person, wants to help, has some ability, some experience in life, and energy, time, and they want to jump in and they want to help at some level. We call that the capable person, or we call it entry-level leadership. And that person has talents, they have skills, they have work experience, they have initiative. But the key is they have a vision only for themselves. Okay, and so I want to help because it's going to make me happy. Second level of leadership is the group leader or the team leader. And you may have different, and I hope in your entity, whether it's your government entity or your organization or business, you have different groups, you have leadership teams. And so this is a team leader. Again, it may be a fairly low level. The team leader helps to achieve the team goals, and there's certain skills that are necessary for that. And the team leader not only has a vision for self, but has a vision for the team. And so as you see, as you rise from one level of leader, your abilities increase, you have all of the abilities of the previous level, and your vision increases. Your vision increases for yourself, the vision increases, now have a vision for the team, you understand the goals and the strategies and the priorities for that level of leadership. And so the very key, I'll probably summarize this again when we finish up, the next level is the manager. And the manager oversees many teams. And so the manager organizes human and material resources. Human resources, material resources, financial resources, and the manager has a vision for the department. And so skills increase and vision increases. The next level is what I call the effective leader. The effective leader is the senior leader. Maybe it's the country director of an organization, or maybe it's the senior pastor or senior leader of a church, or maybe it's the owner of the business, or a higher level than whatever the next level up in your entity is. From the manager, it's the person who oversees everything. And that effective leader, his skills, his or her skills are, they have vision, they know where they're going, we know where the entity is going, they can inspire others, and they can direct others, and prepares the way. Remember, go back to the lesson on the difference between a manager and a leader, because there's a big difference between a manager and a leader. There has to be a shift to go to that level between level 3 and level 4. And of course, the effective leader has a long-term vision for the entity, for the organization, for the church, the school, the business, government organization, whatever it is, government entity, whatever it is. And then the fifth level that we'll talk about now is what I call the executive leader. And the executive leader, that is the highest level of leadership, if we're looking at leadership on a rung like that. And the executive leader has all the skills of all the levels below him or her, also inspires, draws commitment, casts the vision, but the difference is the executive leader does not only have a vision for the here and now. The executive leader will have a vision for the future. The executive leader has a vision for the next generation. Now, it's possible that there's a fine difference between the effective leader and the executive leader, but the difference is one of them has a vision for this year, the next 2 or 3 years, we have a strategic plan for the next 2 or 3 years, but the executive leader, like Bill Gates, like Steve Jobs, like people like that, they think not just for this generation, and they're thinking and they're planning and they're strategizing for the next generation. Can you imagine that if you're a business person and you own one business and you're not just thinking of what you're going to receive, what you're going to accomplish, your income, but you're thinking of the next generation as well. What's going to happen when I'm off the scene for my children and for the whoever comes up after me to run this business or run this multiple businesses, if it's a church, if it's an organization, especially thinking not just for the next 2 or 3 years, you're thinking we're looking for the next generation. And this leader, he or she thinks and plans for the long-term future into the next generation. He wants to carry his organization into the next generation, into the next 15, 20, 30 years. And so has a vision. He sees and pays attention to new ideas. This kind of a leader pays attention to new ideas, pays attention to trends, pays attention to changes in society and changes in technology, and adjusts his strategy to be relevant in the next generation as well. I hope that you understand the difference. And again, all of this is not an in-depth teaching. This is a summary. I would encourage you to contact me at growingleaders75@gmail.com and get my PowerPoint. You're not going to remember all of this. You're not going to be able to write it all down, but I want to give it to you for free. My PowerPoint presentation that has the PowerPoint slides and has my personal notes underneath, because this is something that you need. This is something that you need to communicate to all of your staff, all of your employees. Your entire organization needs to have this kind of thinking. And by the way, I do have a series, Leadership 101. And the purpose of Leadership 101 is to help you develop your personal capacity and to develop the capacity of your staff. You can use Leadership 101. Their videos are between 25 and 30 minutes, and there's notes that go along with them. Again, you contact me, I'll give you the notes for free, and you can do this as a course for your staff or volunteers. You can do it as a seminar. You can do it at a weekly staff meeting. You can do it in small groups and discuss it. But Leadership 101 is helping you to create a leadership culture in your entity. So I encourage you to look on my YouTube under Leadership 101 and watch those videos and find some way that you can use them. I'm doing this for you. And so the characteristics of this kind of a leader, effective leader, they prepare their successor. They don't just pop off the scene and whoever comes on. They're looking because they're thinking for the future. They're thinking long-term generation. And so they're looking around who has the characteristics that are necessary to carry this further. And I can just say for myself, I have been a missionary in Cambodia, and I have served in Cambodia at this point for 25 years. I always, from the beginning, had the plan to work myself out of a job. And so this kind of a thinking is the kind of a thinking that I had. And so we had an international organization that has helped tens of thousands of youth gain marketable job skills. We've helped the poor in almost every province in Cambodia. We have education in the capital city. We have churches who do religious work, but as well as humanitarian work. And so my vision from the beginning was not just doing it myself, but knowing that I'm going to be training someone else to do it for me. And now they are. I'm no longer with that organization. I'm no longer the director of it, because now we have indigenous Cambodians that are leading it into the future. And that was the plan from the beginning 25 years ago. And we went through various stages to do that. But again, it's because I'm an effective leader. I think of what's going to happen in the next generation and I prepare for the next generation. And so if I can just summarize to you, move my slide, sorry about that. What do you have to do to rise to the next level of leadership at any level, from the entry level, capable person, all up to the team leader, the manager? You rise up by, one, increasing your ability. If you know what the skills and the kind of thinking that are necessary at the next level, then you start preparing for that. If I'm at level 3 and I know what skills in your business, now I gave some general run-of-the-mill examples of the kind of skills that you would need at each level. But your school, your business, your organization, there's going to be some specific ones that are applicable to you. And so you need to find out, what does the leader of this organization, what is the next level, what do they know? What do they need to know how to do? And what is their thinking? How do you get that? You get it by asking. You get it by spending time with next level leadership, taking them out to coffee and asking them questions. And so what are the skills that are necessary to do what you're doing? Tell me how you think. Why do we do like this, but we don't do like that? And so that's on you. And if you're at that higher level, you need to be looking at the level below you, and you need to be doing the same thing. You need to invite them to coffee. You look for those who have the potential. You feel that they have the potential, and you pick them out. And in Christian terms, we say you disciple them. You mentor them. You prepare them. You sow into them. And you take the initiative to tell them, this is what is necessary to do my job. And I'm just telling you, this is how I've lived for 25 years. And I have multiplied myself at various levels all over the world. And so you need to discover what is necessary to rise to the next level, and then you need to have vision. Broaden your vision, not just for yourself, not just for your team, not just for your department, not just for the entity, but for the next generation as well. So you need to develop your skills, and you need to develop your vision and understanding for what you're doing and what you need to do at the next level. So what we're talking about, always thinking at the next level, thinking for the future, thinking at the next level. So again, my name is Charles McCall. I'm mentoring growing leaders. If you would, I'd like for you to like this video. I'd like you to subscribe to this channel. I'd like you to click the little bell because I've got another mini series I'm going to be working on here shortly, and you don't want to miss that. It's going to be about strategic planning. And so I appreciate that. You can email me at growingleaders75@gmail.com, and I'd be happy to send you anything that I have for free. I also have a blog, a WordPress blog, and it's Charles Edward McCall, I think it's .com, WordPress.com. Again, you can email me, you look in the notes below, and I'll put that information there. So thank you very much, and I wish you the greatest success in your leadership journey.